The magazine Christianity Today says that the church is in a depression epidemic. My next guest says she was a Christian suffering from depression. However, Carol McLeod lived a good life, married a pastor, she graduated from Oral Roberts University, but after five miscarriages, she began battling with depression. I look at your books, and every one of your books has joy in the title, almost every one of them anyway. How can a Christian be depressed? How did it happen?
Well, for me, it was my circumstances, it was my hormones, but depression comes at us from different areas, and Christians, we don't take an immunization shot that immunizes against depression. It's part of one of the battles that we fight this side of heaven. And we do have an enemy,
yes,
he's very strategic in how he comes at us. And so for some people, it is depression. For some people, it might be in their marriage or in their finances.
And depression can take a lot of different turns. I mean,
you
can have a clinical depression where there really is a chemical situation going on in your brain. And there can be situations of circumstances, emotional depression. How did yours manifest itself?
Well, as you know, I went through years of infertility
yes.
and of losing babies. And so the depression that I walked through, Bob, was attached to circumstances, circumstantial depression or traumatic depression, it's called. And also for me, it was hormonal because my hormones were raging after losing five babies and the infertility drugs I was on. So for me, it was a perfect storm. Both things collided.
And what did you do when you began to battle that? I mean, you're in the middle of fighting for babies.
Yes.
I mean, you wanted to be a mother again so desperately.
Right,
you knew
right.
it was a blessing from God. And then the depression kicks in. Were there messages coming into your life that caused the depression, or was it just strictly dealing with the hormones and the circumstances of the miscarriages?
Yeah, I really do think that's what it was for me. It was losing babies, and as you know, I held four of them in my hand. I saw their little faces. I saw that they were perfectly formed, yet there was no life in them. And it was the hormones that I couldn't control. And I was in a deep, dark place, Bob. I mean, everyone who's depressed knows this term, the black hole. Mm-hmm. It was sucking me in. It was calling my name every single day. And honestly, the only reason I got up was for my two sons, because they needed a mom.
And who saw this first? Who recognized it first? Was it you or your husband, your children? Who recognized the fact that this isn't going away? This isn't just the blues after the miscarriage. This is a deep depression.
Well, it was my husband and I noticed it together. Mm-hmm. We realized that I wasn't coping well, that I wasn't engaging in life the way I used to. And so we began to talk it through, and we began to talk it through with a good friend. And then I went to our medical doctor, and he helped me. And I also went to see a counselor who as well helped me peel back the layers of my pain. But it was a long journey. It lasted about 5 years.
But you sat down and you formed a battle plan.
I did.
I mean, you got to look at all the where the attacks are coming from, whether physical, emotional, spiritual, and form that battle plan.
Yeah. You know, so for people who deal with depression, Bob, this is what I say. I say, go see your medical doctor. Do whatever he or she tells you to do. Mm-hmm. Go see a great counselor and allow them to help you. But in addition to those things, don't ever forget the power of your faith. So that's my voice in your emotional health prescription. Don't ever forget the power of your faith. Use all three to combat the depression that's coming your way.
And did that weapon change in how you used it during that time?
Yeah, it did. So Bob, I realized it was my faith that was giving me hope. I realized that when I worshiped the Lord or when I read the Bible, something picked up inside of me. And so I would play Legos with my little boys with the Bible open between my legs. I would do the dishes with the Bible open on the kitchen counter. I would fold laundry with the Bible open on the dryer. I was so addicted to the Word, and still am, that I would write Bible verses on 3x5 cards and laminate them and take them in the shower with me.
Yeah.
So I was never away from the power of the Word of God, because that is really what delivered me from that deep, dark place.
How long did that depression last?
It lasted about 5 years.
Well, in the middle of that, it 2.5 years, then you say, this isn't working. I've got to do something else.
Well, you know,
what gave you the courage and the faith to go on?
I think it was because I wanted to be a good mom. Mm-hmm. I wanted to mother the two little boys that God had given me. Well, I didn't want to, this was their only childhood. And again, I have a great husband who was praying for me, who was believing in me. I had a good family support group, which was strategic mm-hmm. in helping me.
And what's the best thing you can say to husbands right now? I mean, it's a difficult thing. I mean, your husband is a man of great faith, mm-hmm. but it's still a difficult thing for a husband to watch his wife go through the miscarriages, the infertility, that battle, and then in the middle of all that, to have the depression. And what can you say to husbands right now that don't know what to do? They just, you know, how do I deal with this with my wife? She's not the same woman right now that she was when I married her. I don't know how to communicate. What would you tell that husband right now?
Well, I would tell him to be patient, mm-hmm. to be kind, not to accuse, but maybe to ask questions. Honey, is there anything I can do for you today? Honey, is there anything that we could do together as a family that might bring some happiness mm-hmm. to your life? Honey, is there anybody you want to be with or see? Rather than accuse or fix, I encourage men to ask the right questions.
So yeah. often we want to fix things.
Right,
I mean, when my wife asks me a question, I'm assuming that she wants me to go fix it.
Uh-huh.
That's not normal yet. It's, she wants me to listen to what that problem is that she's facing.
Right, exactly, yeah. exactly. And, you know, service really helps a lot. So this might seem like a little thing, Bob, but no woman's going to refuse a man who does the dishes.
That's true.
Who folds a load of laundry.
Does a little cooking now and then.
Yeah. Who takes the kids out to yeah. play. You know, serve your wife. Mm-hmm. Be in tune to what she needs. Do everything you can. And just love her. Just believe in her. Communicate with her and verbally encourage her. Like I said, rather than accuse her, say kind mm-hmm. things to her. Honey, you're going to make it. We can do this together. We've got what it takes. This is not going to last mm-hmm. forever.
And it didn't last forever. But when did you recognize that you're on the other side of this, that the sun was coming up again and it was and there was a dawn? Were there more miscarriages after that point, or did they all take place during that depression? When did you realize you were coming out of this?
I realized I was coming out of it before my circumstances ever changed.
Really?
Yes, it was before I actually held a baby in my arms mm-hmm. that I realized I was coping better with life. I realized that every day wasn't a sad day. I realized that I had so much more to be thankful for. And Bob, this is one thing that I wanted to say, especially to people who are dealing with depression, because sometimes they think that I am Mary Poppins with a Bible, and that is not who I am. I am a girl who's been in the trenches of deep emotional pain, and I figured how to get out by standing on the Word mm-hmm. of God. And if it worked for me, it will work for you. But what I want to say is this, if you don't understand joy, if you don't like joy, sometimes when you're depressed, hearing the word joy is like fingernails on the chalkboard of life, if you know what I mean. I say, okay, then just be thankful. Mm-hmm. Today, think of three things that you can be grateful for, because thankfulness and joy are not very far apart.
Mm-hmm. Where do you start in this word? I mean, if somebody's depressed today, maybe they're not into Bible reading, they're not into memorizing scripture, they're not into Bible study, they may not even be in church, but there's probably a Bible in their home. Where would you tell them to start today?
I would tell them to start in the Psalms, mm-hmm. written chiefly by a man named David, right. who dealt with deep depression, and he was verbal about it. Mm-hmm. He talked about the pit that he was in. He talked about discouragement. So I often encourage people who are dealing with, you know, emotional discouragement, go to the Psalms. And, you know, one of my favorite verses, though, just from another chapter in the Bible, is Nehemiah 8:10. And we know this scripture, the joy of the Lord is your strength. But did you know that the first part of that verse says, be not grieved or depressed, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. And so I I cuddle up to that verse so many times in my life, Bob, because depression still comes knocking at my door. It still tries to get my attention from time to time. But the way I answer the door is through the Word of God. Mm-hmm. And I declare that in His presence there's fullness of joy. All the joy that I need this side of heaven is not at Hawaii. It's not in a box of Godiva chocolates. It's found in spending time with Jesus.
Well, that Nehemiah scripture ought to be one that they do laminate
yes.
and carry with them, stick
yes.
it in their wallet or something, and pull that out and read that.
That's right.
Carol, you do share a lot of joy across the country in doing women's retreats
yes.
and things like this, but also a podcast right now. How can people find you?
Yeah, I actually have two podcasts, Bob. One is on the Charisma Podcast Network,
mm-hmm.
and it's called A Jolt of Joy.
Joy.
I know you're not surprised, but it's a daily Bible yeah. teaching program that they can just access. And then I have a weekly podcast for moms called The Joy of Motherhood. And they can get that at my website or on Google Play or Stitcher. But my website is justjoyministries.com.
If you'd like more information about Jesus Christ or how to connect to a local church, go to our website or Facebook page. We have a lot more resources there that we can connect you with. Plus, I'd like to hear from you.